kids, today we are going to create a math art, very interesting math art, that is an agamograph. Now you ask, what is an agamograph? Great question. An agamograph is an art that uses optical illusion to create the change in the picture when you look at it from different angle. It is like a 3D style of art using two pictures. When they are folded back and forth in accordion style, and as you change your viewing angle from one direction to another, your picture changes. An agamograph first named after Israeli artist Yaakov Agam. He was born in 1928 and he's still alive. He's a great kinetic and illusion and optical artist. So let's start. To make an agamograph, we need one A4 size paper, white, a scale, maybe small or a big, whatever you have, pencil, eraser, pencil colors. I have a lot of pencil colors here. Crayon colors are also fine, but we prefer pencil color because they don't smudge. And a scissor. Please use scissor when you are supervised by any adult. Please don't use scissors on your own. So let's start. First, we are going to put a mark on every 2 cm. For that, we remember 2 cut table. 2 stable. Let's say first we put a mark on 2. And then 2 ones are 2. Let's count like this. 2 twos are 4. Put a mark on 4. 2 threes are 6. Put a mark on 6. 2 fours are 8. Put a mark on 8. And then go on. And we'll left this part. Okay. Now do the same exercise on below this paper also. Same way. Let's do 2 stable, 2 ones are 2, it's 2 cm mark, 2 twos are 4, at 4 we are putting a mark, 2 threes are 6, now then next we'll join these 2 marks, okay, join like this, use a pencil and join these 2 lines. Say 1, 2, yes, we join. Now if you want, you can highlight these lines by sketch pens. Here I am using this color. You can use any color you want. Here I am doing nothing but just highlighting it. After that, put a number on every column, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. We have total 15 columns. Now draw a line below every odd number. Like 1, 3, I have already drawn it, you can see. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13 and 15. same at the bottom of the page also, leave some space and then draw a line like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13 and 15. Okay, so we have a column like this, and after this we have to color this space. This is like a vertical bar, so now we have to color it. Use your favorite colors and like color it, all these vertical bars you have to color it. So I have colored these vertical bars in different colors. You can use as many colors as you want, just spare one color. Don't use one color like I haven't used yellow. So you can spare one color, like any light color or dark color, say yellow or orange or pink. So don't use one color, spare it. And now these bars, now the bars which have even numbers, we are going to draw a geometrical figure here. You can draw any of the figure. I am drawing triangle. So first let's measure this bar. This is around 15.5 centimeter from this mark to this mark. You have to put a point in a middle. It will be around here. Yes. So now we have put a point on the middle, and we are going to join the line from this line. This is the line which is drawn below this 15. Yahan se we are going to draw a line only on the vertical bars below this even number. So let's start with 2. Mid here, and same here also, from this point to this point. Yes, from last. Okay, now if you wanted to highlight with a sketch pen, you can do it. And if you don't have a sketch pen, you can highlight it using any pencil color. Or if you don't want to do it, let it be. It is also looking fine. And now color it. Color it with the color which you haven't used. Like I haven't used yellow here. So I'm going to put yellow, one color, in every bar. So after that it will look like this. We have used same color, the triangle which we have drawn, I have used same color. So we have to use same color. So spare only one color. I haven't used yellow in this vertical bar, so I have used yellow color. You can use any color of your choice which you haven't used in this vertical bar. Okay, now we are going to fold it like an accordion style. So first we have to make a crease. Okay. So you have to put a scale on a first line. 1 is written here, so you have to put it over here, and you have to fold it just like this. To fold it, and then you have to put it on the second line, put a scale like this and fold it. Yes, you have to make a nice decrease. Like this. Put the scale on this line and then fold it. So you have to fold every, you have to fold from, you have to fold where you have, where we have drawn a line. Yes, like this. Yes, nice and easy. So after making fold, the paper will look like this. If you can see it, we have a fold like this. Now we are, as I told you, now we are going to fold it like an accordion side, accordion style. First, we have to draw it. First, we have to fold it out and then in and then like this. We already have a fold, so we just have to fold it in an accordion style like this. We have a shape like this. Okay. Right. We have like this. Now, what we are going to do, we are going to cut it. Cut this. Cut it from where we have drawn the line, like this. Like I have told you, don't use the scissor on your own. Take the help from any adult or do it under the supervision of any adult. Okay, so now let's fold it once again. Yes, and your agamograph is ready. So this is an agamograph. We have done it. Now instead of triangle, you can use any other geometrical shape like square, rectangle, diamond, and it will look very interesting when you look at it from different angle. When you change the angle, the picture changes. I hope you have enjoyed making this easy and interesting math project. See you later. Bye bye.